Hi, I'm Dr. Elliot Adam from ElliotOracle.com, and it's time for this week's Oracle Reveal. So earlier today on Instagram, I placed up a photo with three different animals on it. The animals were the lion, the owl, and the whale. And so I asked you to ask yourself which animal was calling to you, to use your intuition, and which animal was getting stuck in your head. And that is the animal that's got the message for you. So if you're just joining us right now, ask yourself, which animal is kind of getting stuck in your head? Is it the lion, is it the owl, or is it the whale? And let's start with the lion people. So the first card we're gonna go over for the lion people is where it's best to place your focus at this time. And we have the death card, which indicates that things are really transforming for the lion people right now. There's a letting go of the old ways of life right now. And it's also a time to surrender to some pretty major changes that are happening. Whenever we see the death card, it often indicates that there's a big change that might cause some anxiety. And oftentimes it'll tell you that the thing you're anxious about changing right now is exactly the thing that needs to go right now. You need to clear out some space for new beginnings to happen. Always with this death card, you can see the sun that's rising over the horizon between those two towers. And that's indicating that every death is followed by a rebirth. But in order to really enjoy that rebirth, you have to let go of the old. So this card is saying that it's time to let the old be swept away. Also, for the lion people, if you did pick lion, lion is a very regal animal. It is an archetype that is known when it arrives on the scene. Everybody looks at it and sees it. And so this could just be a time also, if you're attracted to lion right now, where you need to step into your confidence and really step into your courage. And you also need to step into your dignity and your majesty at this time, especially as you're going through some big changes. And the next card is advice from your inner wisdom. And it's the Four of Wands. So one of the things that might be going through some changes for you is socially. Whenever we see the Four of Wands, it's indicating connections with other people. And this could indicate outgrowing old modes of thinking or old organizations or even people that you've been operating around for quite some time. And now you're kind of attracted to something new or different, and that's totally fine. Also, the death card in the past can indicate it's time to let go of something in order to make room for some joy. The Four of Wands is one of the most whimsical cards in the tarot. It's just all about losing your inhibitions, having fun, and it's also a card of revelry. And so this could just be a period right now where you really want to let go of something that's been very heavy or difficult and feel free again and feel like you can celebrate. And then also, the Four of Wands and the Death card are both cards of rites of passage. Here on the Four of Wands, they're celebrating a holiday or a wedding, and then also the Death card is a big momentous life change. And so when both of these cards come up, it could indicate that soon you'll be celebrating a huge rite of passage or a huge personal transformation. And then finally, for the lion people, we have a mythic archetype that's gonna help you through this next week. And you've got the goddess Artemis. She's the chaste goddess of the hunt. She's not married, she's not ruled by any man. She's completely free to run off in the woods and just let her hair down underneath the light of the moon. And when she comes back into your cards, she's really saying it's time to reconnect with what makes you an individual and to feel free at this time, to feel unencumbered. And so again, with that death archetype or that death card in the past, it's just time to let go of anything that's weighing you down or limiting your freedom. The Four of Wands and that Artemis archetype are both about being free and really reclaiming your power that way. So this is definitely an intense and magical time for the lion people. Next is for the people who picked the owl. And the owl is known for being able to see through the dark and see what other people can't see. If you're attracted to owls or if that's one of your totems, often other people will feel a little uncomfortable around you at first. They might even be a little resistant to you because you're seeing things that maybe they don't want you to see, or they're going to get that sense that you are able to look through them, even though you might not even care. So the first card for the owl people is what it's best to place your focus on for this next week. And we have the Six of Pentacles. Now, this is a card of generating good karma. And sometimes we find ourselves in the position of the merchant on this card, and sometimes we find ourselves in the position of the people who need help on the card. But this is a wonderful card of reciprocity and also giving and receiving. But this is a card also of balance. You can see that the merchant is holding the scales. And so the importance right now of this card is saying you need to place your focus on the balance of how much you're giving of yourself, and then also how much you're allowing yourself to receive. if you just do one, you're going to be depleted, or you're going to take on too much and then feel like you're owing something. And so this card is really saying to make sure that you're really allowing yourself to accept good things from others as well. The Six of Pentacles is also just a wonderful card of helpful people. So this could be a time where not only are you being a helpful person for other people, but you might also be receiving some help as well. For the next card for the Owl people, it's advice from their inner wisdom. Oh, and that's the Queen of Cups. And the Queen of Cups is, of all the tarot cards, she's the one who holds the most elaborately decorated chalice. And this means that she prizes her feelings. She prizes the time she spends reconnecting with her inner landscape. And so when the Queen of Cups comes up, she's calling you back home. She's calling you back to your heart center. And she's also non-judgmental. She's very caring. She's very compassionate. And when she comes up next to that Six of Pentacles archetype, this could be just a time where help is trying to find you, or there's someone who's trying to be supportive, or maybe even your own higher self is trying to be more supportive of you, but you need to make some time to really reconnect with those feelings and let them come back to the surface. These are both cards as well of allowing yourself to receive. And so I think that that's going to be a big theme as we're going through this next week. And it's just basically telling you to ask yourself, how are you blocking the ability to receive from other people? Are you telling people, oh no, I can handle it, don't worry about it? Or are you really just saying, you know, thanks for doing it, I do appreciate that. And then finally, we have the mythic archetype for the Owl people, and that's Hercules, or Heracles in Greek. He's the god of strength. He's the one who completes the 12 labors. And so there is this sense of service that's kind of weaving its way through all three of these cards. You have the merchant who is of service. You've got the nurturing queen who's of service to her subjects and her children. And then you got the hero Heracles, who is also of service to finish his labors. And so this is a time to really be courageous and really step up to the fore and really also tap into your inner strength. One of the feelings or emotions that you might want to most reconnect with at this time is that inner strength in order to meet the challenges at hand. And then finally, we have the Whale people. And the Whale is the magical record keeper. It's the one who knows all the history and also delves into his own personal history. So this could be a time where you're really reconnecting with your heart as well. The first card for the Whale is the Hermit reversed. And the Hermit reversed usually indicates that after a period of withdrawal or really doing a lot of soul searching, just like the Whale, you're coming back up for air again. You're coming back to the surface with new insights. And when we see the Hermit reversed, he's telling you it's time to reconnect with other people. And so this is just a time to share again and just allow yourself to come back into society or around other people, or even to share your insights or to connect again with others. Advice from your inner wisdom. Wow, pretty big cataclysmic change cards, not only for the Whale people, but also the Lion people earlier. And also a similar theme here, because we have that Tower card, which is so similar to the Death card. It's about sweeping away the old. But in this case, when we see the Tower next to the Hermit reversed, it's almost as if you're getting out of your head. You can see the crown of the Tower is popping off and the people are falling back to earth. You're getting out of your head and you're coming back to the world. And so this could just be a time where you're snapping out of a sense of denial that you're alone or that it's you against the world. This could be a time, again, where it's important to reconnect. And finally, for the Whale people is the mythic archetype that's going to help you moving forward. And that's the god of wine, Dionysus. Oftentimes he'll come up when it's time to just loosen up. And especially when we got these heavy cards of the Tower and the Hermit reverse, these are major arcana cards, you've been really handling quite a few heavy things. And Dionysus is saying, it's time to relax. It's time to enjoy yourself. And again, I'm going to throw back to that Lion archetype. That Dionysus archetype is so similar to the Four of Wands that came up earlier for the Lion people. So if you pick the Whale and the Lion, this message is definitely coming home for you. But this is a time to get out of anything restrictive, anything that's made you feel trapped or stuck or isolated especially. It's time to reconnect with the world, reconnect with friends, and just also have a really wonderful, fun time. So that is this week's Oracle. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, I do invite you to go to ElliottOracle.com and book a personal session with me. These little mini readings are wonderful, but they're nothing compared to a one-on-one session that goes all into your cares and concerns. So otherwise, I do hope you all have a wonderful week, and I will see you again. Take care.